The first step in specimen preparation is to section the roots off. This is then followed by rotating the tooth into a vertical position and sectioning through the halves of the tooth. This gives us two usable bonding surfaces for bond testing. We do always want to use a diamond saw. In this case, it's just a small hobby craft type saw with a platform to allow you to stabilize your hands on the platform. And this makes very quick work of the process while keeping you very safe. The next step after sectioning is to mount a plastic plate against a grinding wheel so that the teeth don't slip through when you start to grind these small flats. The flat will be necessary to have present so that we can put that on the tape in the mold and hold that down. So if we don't have that flat, the tooth will wobble and rock when we pour the acrylic around it. I like to use a small piece of plastic to hold the sectioned tooth against the grinding wheel. We're using the mild or the fine grinding disc on this. In this case, you can see I've put a little notch in the plastic to help hold the teeth in place during grinding. Otherwise, the tooth specimen might slip to one side or another. You can use anything to press it against it, but you've got to make these small flats to help the teeth settle down into the mold and lock onto the piece of plastic. The flat is only going to be just barely into the enamel, typically not even into the dentin yet. The next step in the process is to take one of the molds and put tape over the back of the mold. And once we have put tape on the back of the mold, we can kind of fold the tape over so it makes for easy retrieval. And then we want to take a paper towel and burnish the back of that so that the methacrylate doesn't leak out. From here, we will blot dry, just a little bit blot dry, the tooth section with a that has the small flat on it and place those down in the center of the mold. Usually, I like to put it down in the mold and kind of press against it to lock it onto the tape. This ensures that the methacrylate won't push the tooth around during pouring and so that the tooth can stay centered. Finish placing all the specimens into the molds, ensuring that the teeth never go dry during the process. After all the specimens have been placed, you can ensure that they are appropriately stuck down to the plastic and won't move simply by picking it up and taking a closer look to inspect that they are still in place. Pre-measure your powder and liquid out and place them into a paper cup for mixing and pouring. Most manufacturers have slightly different ratios of their liquid to powder, so find which one you like to create a type of mix that is like a wet pancake batter, something that is just showing some signs of viscosity, but still not too thick to pour, but also not so thin that it's just a thin, watery mixture. At this point, you can test and add a little more powder or add a little more liquid if you wanted to tune it in, but finding your pre-measured volumes should help you get the right mix consistently every time. Increase the cup, start pouring the wells full of the methacrylate. It won't matter if you have a little bit of overflow because it will simply go down between the spaces on this particular mold. In this case, you can see I run out about here, and I have now made a next level mix, and we would continue pouring. As soon as the material really starts to harden up, which is usually somewhere around 10 or 15 minutes, you can tap the back to see if they are actually starting to harden. If they have hardened to the point where they're still just a little bit pliable, they're going to start building heat. So we want to now put those into a water tray to take the temperature off to keep it cooler. After the specimens have now set and hardened, you can peel the tape off and go ahead and punch the specimens out. I like to use a plastic rod so that I don't damage the mold. These specimens should come out so easily that you won't have to fight much to get them out. So in this case, I have a small tray that I can set them in that makes easy work of this. You can just actually bump them out. Even without a hammer, you could bump them out most of the time. But here you can see that it's just a very short and light tap to break them out. Once they are all broken out, you can now return them to a tray of water or a bin of water, however you're storing. From this point forward, we are now going to grind them. So the grinding step is going to look like this. We need to fit them into this cup, and sometimes they won't fit. So we will grind on the side of the specimen just to kind of take off any flash that helps it fit in. Most of the time, this step is necessary to allow an easy slip fit in. If you push them in, you're going to have a hard time getting them out if it's a heavy friction fit. So we'll grind the front, and each time we'll check to look for the reveal of dent or enamel that we're interested in. And so in this case, I can't see too much dentin, so I'll regrind. Here is the specimen reground, and we'll dry it off and take a quick look to see if we can see the dentin enamel junction. So it will take several steps of grinding most of the time just to find out where you've got a large window of dentin to bond to. After the dentin has been revealed, you can grind the back. Here you can see the specimen is not fitting again, so grinding the sides again just to take off any of that extra circumference, push it on and grind the back so that we have a level or parallel top and bottom to the specimen so that it's not wobbling around while we do our bond testing. And when we grind the tooth down, we will see much of the time that we don't really have as much dentin exposed as we were looking for. In this case, you can see it's kind of halfway up that tooth. And so I'll grind just a little deeper so that I can get a little better look at that dentin that we want to bond to. So back into grinding, drying again, and you can see it's just pushed up a little higher so that I have a little better reveal of the dentin that we're going to be trying to bond to. Now, we don't want to be bonding to enamel when we're trying to bond to dentin, and we don't want to bond to dentin when we're trying to bond to enamel. So this is kind of a delicate balance of looking at what surfaces we want to bond to. So looking at this one more time, just quickly, grinding the sides so that it fits in the mandrel cup. Now grinding the face, and we'll do several grinding passes to get the right dentin reveal that we're looking for. So pushing a little further in, you can see in this next shot that we do now have a level specimen and a specimen with a large enough window of dentin to bond to. Now we're grinding the face for a final finish with the fine grinding wheel.